don't know what they referred to themselves as. We don't know what language they spoke. We know that they're prehistoric hunter-gatherers at the end of the Ice Age. The whole valley, and probably this little side canyon here, was occupied for the last 13,000 years. This site, this rock shelter right here, has been illegally looted. It's one of the most extreme examples of looting of a rock shelter that I've ever seen. So the archaeological field school is really one of the gems of the anthropology department at Fort Lewis, because it allows students to go out into the field and participate and actually do archaeology in a hands-on environment. And then we bring all of that material back to the classrooms and use it in subsequent classes down the road and in student research as well. So out of the hundreds of artifacts that we've been finding over the last 5.5 weeks that we've spent out here, this is a small example of some of the more diagnostic artifacts that tell us things about specific time periods when people were occupying and inhabiting the valley. These are typically things that most people would consider arrowheads, but they're actually spear points that would have been used prior to the invention of arrowhead technology. And so by looking at how these things are made over time, we can start reconstructing those daily lives of past peoples thousands of years ago. So this particular artifact is really exciting. It dates to probably somewhere around 13,000 years ago. Probably the oldest artifact that we've found out here all summer. We can compare that with examples that have been found complete and intact, and look at the similarities of both the flake scars that have been taken off of the rock, and also the overall outline of how they're being made. And so that's really how we date a lot of these stone tools like this. Everyone participating in the class, this is the very first time that they've done hands-on archaeology in the wild, as it were, right?
All of the faculty that we have here have really great real-world experience and are very well-known in their field, so it's really a great opportunity that we get to study under them.
I want to know more about why people were here, what we were doing, how we lived. I mean, it's pretty fascinating. It's the one question I've always kind of wondered as a kid, and that's kind of what got me into archaeology. Even if it's more salvage archaeology, it's still great because you learn who's been here, who has, like, basically who hasn't, what's been destroyed and what isn't destroyed.
This is the largest rock shelter here in this kind of side canyon. So because of that, the looters probably really targeted this. The BLM has been trying to get us to take a look at it to see to what extent actually the looters damaged the site. They wouldn't have kept going if they weren't finding important things that were probably bringing high dollar on the antiquities market, on the black market. We and the BLM thought that they had just spent a couple of days on site, the looters, and dug a few pits and piled up a bunch of dirt out front. Now that we've spent 5.5 weeks out here, it really looks like they did a pretty good job of destroying the site. Basically, I think they just went through, dug a trench across the front of it, threw everything out that they weren't keeping out here on the slope, and then just worked their way back to the wall, mining the entire shelter down to bedrock. It's actually really significant that we've spent all of our summer out here documenting this, because it's looting at a much larger scale than anyone thought was happening out here. This is you want to kind of think about it, like almost industrial or commercial scale looting of archaeological sites and cultural resources. So our work here this summer is really going a long ways in helping the Bureau of Land Management and other land managers, public land managers in the greater Four Corners area, understand the extent of looting and working in the future how to combat it and address some of these issues on public lands that are really to benefit all of us.
This doesn't even feel like a class. It just feels like playing in the dirt and camping for 6 weeks, which is a lot of fun.
Right after I graduate in December, I am going to the Northern Delta region of Egypt, where we'll be working on excavating a potential old temple.
What better classroom setting is there than like a rock shelter?